on Local 24 News, meteorologist Chelsea Chandler with a Mid-South certified most accurate forecast.
All right, well, I would say nice and quiet, but we have already seen at least one shower right here that has produced some lightning. So one storm this morning that has been continually moving east. Otherwise, pretty quiet, but you can see around the area we do have rain. And y'all, when I walked outside, it is a mess out there. You can just feel the humidity is awful. I mean, it is incredibly uncomfortable. Rain chances today, 40%. Most of those rain chances are going to come in the afternoon. Then we start to see our week drying out. 30% chance tomorrow, 10% Wednesday, completely dipping on Thursday, but climbing back as we head towards the weekend, of course, because our rain chances, of course, would return on the weekend. All right, as far as what's going on heat-wise, we have a heat advisory for all of our Arkansas counties. Most of their Mississippi counties, it's Coahoma, Quitman, Tunica, Tate, DeSoto, Marshall, and Panola County. In Tennessee, it's Shelby, Fayette, Tipton, Lauderdale and Haywood County, and this goes until at least 7 p.m. tonight. Go ahead and expect that to be extended, if not even upgraded or expanded. So we'll be watching that, of course, today to give you information. Right now, the temperature is 81 degrees, and it is 5 o'clock in the morning. The rest of the area in the mid to upper 70s, I'm telling you, it is awful. If you're going to go out for a walk, be prepared instantly to have moisture over your entire body. 80 degrees at 6 o'clock. As we head through the rest of the day, you're going to see temperatures climbing into the low 90s. Again, as we head into the afternoon hours, that's when you start to see the chance for those showers and thunder showers. Now, as far as our heat index, it hurts me. Oh, it hurts me even to see it. It's 94, feels like 109. Again, if we get up to 110 and stay there, we could see an excessive heat warning. The rest of the week, 106, 105, 107, 108. Oh, I felt like an auctioneer just then, and not in a fun way. Again, remember to stay hydrated. That is the biggest key. As early and often as possible, be drinking water. You want to frequently take breaks. You're going inside, finding shade. Make sure that you are wearing loose-fitting, light-colored clothing. Checking on your loved ones, your pets as well. They can have a heat illness, and of course, looking before you lock. Now, the difference between heat exhaustion and heat stroke. Heat exhaustion, you feel faint, you're dizzy, clammy. You've got a weak pulse, muscle cramps. You just need to get inside, cool down, and hydrate. Now, if you stop sweating, have a throbbing headache, and a very fast, rapid heart rate, then you need to call 911 because you could have a stroke. So that would be obviously not problematic. Your temperatures, when they're this high, just at 90 degrees, again, 109 in 30 minutes, 133. Well, it's going to be even hotter than that, so very lethal. That's why it's so important to look before you lock. Now, as we get through today, we'll see clouds build as we head towards the afternoon. You see the chance for those scattered showers and thunder showers into the afternoon. They clear out though by the evening, and then we look pretty good as we head into the overnight and into the next day. So looking at your 7-day forecast, 94 today, 93 tomorrow, 96 this week, and I don't want to think, we already know at least Thursday what it's going to feel like, but it's just hot and it's horrible. So please take care of yourself and your family today and the rest of the week, including all of your pets. So we'll keep an eye on that. And now the roadways. The good thing is right now, nothing's really happening on the road. I haven't seen any accidents or delays.